but in a standalone mode, blind search is required. Why blind search is required? UE scan blindly and detect SSB, since UE need to detect this before it get any RRC, because पावर ऑन होने के बाद यूई को उस टाइम पे कोई आरआरसी मैसेज नहीं होता, कोई मीब नहीं मिलता, कोई सीब नहीं मिलता. सो यूई नीड टू डू ब्लाइंडली एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड द एसएसबी लोकेशन, राइट? बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी आर डूइंग ब्लाइंडली सर्च इन स्टैंड अलोन मोड. व्हाई यूई ट्राइंग टू डिकोड एसएसबी? बिकॉज यूई वांट टू डिकोड पीएसएस एंड एसएसएस टू फाइंड द फिजिकल सेल आईडी, एंड पीएसएस एंड एसएसएस एग्जिस्ट इन एसएसबी ब्लॉक, सो दैट यूई वांट टू डिकोड एसएसबी फर्स्ट. UE need to search SSB based on ARC and raster. Again, ARC and raster come. Now here, concept will come of global synchronization number, channel raster, synchronization raster. What is the channel number? What is channel raster? What is synchronization raster? What is GSN? So a lot of the question is coming one by one. I am trying to decode all the question. So channel raster first is that. चैनल रस्टर कॉन्सेप्ट इज ऑल्सो इन LTE में भी ये कॉन्सेप्ट है चैनल रस्टर का. सो चैनल रस्टर फॉर LTE इज 100 किलो हर्ट्ज फॉर ऑल बैंड एंड सेंटर फ्रीक्वेंसी मस्ट बी ए होल नंबर मल्टीपल ऑफ 100 किलो हर्ट्ज. अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, सेंटर फ्रीक्वेंसी मस्ट बी ए होल नंबर मल्टीपल ऑफ 100 किलो हर्ट्ज. सो इसका मतलब है इन LTE PSS एंड SSS exist in central frequency. So how UE will reach on central frequency? UE will scan the whole the band in multiple of 100 kilohertz raster where PSS and SSS exist, because in central frequency PSS and SSS exist in the LTE, right? So suppose that one frequency bandwidth is there, so in every 100 kilohertz it will try to scan and it will reach to the central frequency. Once it will reach to the central frequency, you will get it the PSS and SSS and PBCH, so that you scan whole band in a multiple of 100 kilohertz in LTE. So channel raster in LTE is 100 kilohertz. So what is synchronization raster in 5GNR? Concept of channel raster in 5GNR is the same as that of LTE, but if frequency interval या channel raster is 100 kilohertz like LTE, so search time will be a longer and higher performance requirement for the terminal, right? LTE 100 kilohertz, but in 5G frequency range is very high. So in that case, if it will try to scan on every 100 kilohertz, every 100 kilohertz channel raster, it will take too much time. So it will affect the UE performance. 5G frequency is very narrow. Therefore, in order to search the PSS and SSS faster, 5G frequency is very narrow, so it need to be searched very fast. So 5GNR adopt a different approach from LTE. SSB position is not fixed because of different subcarrier spacing. There is limited set of possible location in each band, also called a synchronization raster. So SSB limited possible location पे exist करता है. SSB limited possible location पे exist करता है. इस possible location को ही synchronization raster कहते हैं. UE perform SSB search in this sparse and specific possible location. Similar to the understanding of the channel raster, synchronization raster can be considered as a minimum frequency interval of a central frequency point of SSB. Here you can see that, suppose that SSB is available on this part. Here it is available. Now you want to search the SSB. So this small part, we can say that this is a synchronization raster. So every time it will scan and will try to reach the SSB central point. It SSB central point it will try to reach. So it will scan this small part. A small part, you can say that granularity, yeah, you can say that synchronization raster, yeah, a small width it will try to scan. So and every step it will scan and it will come to reach this central point of SSB. So this is called SS raster, yeah, you can say that GSCN, yeah, this is also SS reference point. SSREF also we can say that this central point of SSB is SSREF, yeah, you can say that GSCN. ये small part को scan करते हुए UE will search to the center frequency point of SSB. So this small part is synchronization raster. और जो सेंटर फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ SSB इज GSTN या SSREF. GSTN या SSREF. What is GSTN? Again same thing. If UE need to search SSB based on ARPCN raster, it would take a long time. Since ARPCN raster is very narrow, so it would be a good to define SSB searching frequency in wider step. This is usage and purpose of GSTN. So we are using the wider step, that is synchronization raster. We are scanning the full bandwidth in a synchronization raster, whatever width is there. After scanning, we are trying to figure out the GSTN. We are able to find out the GSTN value, GSTN point of the SSB location. So no question is that how much raster or frequency width can be used to scan the whole frequency bandwidth. What is the width is required? It will scan on the frequency synchronization raster. It will scan the one specific width. So what is the width of that scanning? So if it will use 100 kilohertz like LT, if it will use 100 kilohertz raster to scan, it will take a long time, right? So for 5G NR need to use wider frequency width to scan whole frequency. Here you can see that position of PSS and SSS in LT and 5G NR in the carrier. Position of SSB is not fixed in 5G NR. You can see that it is not a central frequency. There is not, maybe SSB can be placed here, maybe it will be placed on below. So position is not fixed for the SSB. But in LT, PSS and SSS exist on central frequency point. So you know that location of PSS, SSS in LT. But in 5G NR, you doesn't know the SSB. So what you will do, it will use the small width and it will try to reach on SSB of central frequency point, that is SSREF, yeah, you can say that GSTN. Now in this image, SSB block is available here in this point, and this is a frequency domain, this is time domain. Central frequency of SSB is a multiple of synchronization raster. Again, I am telling, central frequency of SSB is multiplied of synchronization raster. Now, synchronization raster ka jo size hai, usi ke multiplied mein SSB is existing in frequency and time domain. So that if know the width, if know the formula, then we can calculate it and you is able to search the SSB location. So position of SSB synchronization signal is variable and doesn't necessarily have to be placed at a center frequency. So ये जरूरत नहीं है कि वो central frequency पे SSB हो, कहीं भी हो सकता है frequency and time domain location में. So in every synchronization raster, this a small size it will scan. One, suppose that a small size is 1 MHz. 1 MHz is not there, it is more than 1 MHz synchronization raster size is there. Suppose that 1 MHz is there. So in every 1 MHz, it will try to scan and it will reach to the central frequency point of SSB. So in 5G NR, what is the raster value? Yeah, you can say that what is the step size for the scan the frequency. In example, suppose that we are taking 3.7 and 4.5 GHz band, that means FR1 frequency we are taking. Then SSB can be placed every 1.44 MHz step size. SSB can be placed every 1.44 MHz step size. But if it is FR2, that means 28 GHz band, then SSB can be placed at 17.28 MHz step size. So SSB will be placed at 70.28 MHz step size. Synchronization raster divide a carrier bandwidth in finite number of locations where SSB can be deployed and all possible SSB center frequency point across the NR spectrum called GSTN. Again, I am repeating, synchronization raster divide carrier bandwidth into finite number of locations where SSB can be deployed and all possible SSB center frequency point across the NR spectrum called GSTN, Global Synchronization Channel Number.
तो फ्रेंड्स, आज का वीडियो मैं यहीं पे समाप्त करता हूँ। थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। अगर आपको मेरा वीडियो पसंद आया हो तो प्लीज़ लाइक एंड कमेंट करें, और अगर आप मेरे चैनल पे नए हैं तो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब करें, क्योंकि मैं हमेशा कुछ नए टॉपिक पे वीडियो लाता रहता हूँ और उसका नोटिफिकेशन आपको मिलता रहेगा। सो थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग वीडियो।